jury in understanding the evidence presented and determine the facts in this case. In this case, the defense is going to call Janice M. Johnson, offered as an expert in blood spatter and crime scene reconstruction. You are not bound by such expert's opinion, but you should consider each opinion and give it the weight to which you deem it is entitled, whether that be great or slight, or you may reject it. In examining each opinion, you may consider the reasons given for it, if any, and you may also consider the qualifications and credibility of the expert. It's always within the special function of the jury to determine whether the facts on which the answer or testimony of an expert is based actually exist. The value or weight of the opinion of the expert is dependent upon and no stronger than the facts on which it is based. In other words, the probative value of the opinion will depend upon whether, from all of the evidence in the case, you find that those facts are true. You may, in fact, determine from the evidence in the case and from the facts that form the basis of the opinion are true, are not true, or are true in part only, and in light of such findings, you should decide what effect such determination has upon the weight to be given to the opinion of the expert. Your acceptance or rejection of the expert opinion will depend, therefore, to some extent, on your findings as to the truth of the facts relied upon. The ultimate determination of whether or not the state has proven defendant's guilt beyond a reasonable doubt is to be made only by the jury. Thank you. Please call your witness.
Thank you. We would call Jean Johnson to the stand, Judge.
Then went to the state of Florida
What is the Florida Department of Law Enforcement?
The Florida Department of Law Enforcement is the state agency within Florida. It would be like your highway patrol and your state crime labs in New Jersey.
Okay, I'm sorry to interrupt you. Go
ahead. That's okay. But I was trained by the Florida Department of Law Enforcement. There was 15 analysts that were trained all at the same time. So the state wanted people to respond to major crime scenes, and the governor basically slated 15 positions, and I was one of the, I'm referred to as the original 15. They wanted someone with no experience so they could train us the way the laboratory wanted evidence collected and preserved for comparison purposes. After I got out of my initial training, I was under supervision for 1 year, and during that year, I was I did a secondary training in bloodstain pattern analysis. I was a member of six people that were trained in bloodstain pattern analysis to do bloodstains at major crime scenes within the state of Florida. During that training, we also did a paper, a manual, that was used in the crime scene in the laboratory for future training of other analysts. Once I completed my internship and my training, I then began doing independent casework, covering 10 counties within Northwest Florida. So that would be from Escambia County to the Apalachicola River, which is over 200 miles. We would assist local law enforcement agencies, police departments, sheriff's offices, DEA, FBI, Marine Patrol, Highway Patrols, you name it, we did it, okay? So we were trying to do any type of crime scene by ourselves. So we had to be extremely independent, and we had a lot of training. Also, I received training in buried bodies and surface skeletons. And I worked with the Florida Department of Law Enforcement doing crime scenes in the 10 counties, and also bloodstain evidence throughout the state of Florida, which is 67 counties. And I also have been tendered as an expert witness in many courts within the state of Florida and externally as well. After working with the Florida Department of Law Enforcement.
Can I interrupt you one more time?
Yes.
I'm so sorry. So what year approximately did you start at the Florida Department of Law Enforcement?
I started in 1979.
And how many years were you employed at the Florida Department of Law Enforcement?
Until 2001.
And I think you answered this, but I just want to clear it up. You were involved in the processing of crime scenes and forensic analysis. And if you had to guesstimate how many cases in that period of time you were involved in, how many would you say?
Oh, thousands of cases. Thousands and thousands. Because we would routinely be on call 7 days in a row, and anything that happened within that 7 day span, we responded to. So anything from a quadruple homicide to a total burglary.
Did you ever have to testify as an expert in your capacity at the Florida Department of Law Enforcement?
Oh, hundreds of times, hundreds and hundreds. Regular cases and also death penalty cases.
And when you were called as an expert during your employment at the Florida Department of Law Enforcement, were you called as an expert by the government?
Yes, I was.
So, I'm sorry, I interrupted you. After the Florida Department of Law Enforcement, take us to your next position.
Okay, in 2001, I was offered a position with the Escambia County Sheriff's Office to go over there and be a manager and supervise the crime scene and latent section, and also to establish a crime laboratory. So, because of all the bad logs in crime laboratories, they wanted to do their own independently. So, I was retained and accepted that position as a supervisor. And in 2004, I had enough time then with the FBI and the state of Florida that I retired. Before I left the Florida Department of Law Enforcement, I actually started my own business, which was forensic pieces, which I still have. So this is my 20th year of private practice. I first started out as a training business for law enforcement, and then I saw a need for laboratory analysis and also casework. So I do casework for prosecution and defense.
Now, you mentioned training. Give the jury a little bit of an idea. Are you training just in Florida, or are there other parts of the country that you're training? education degrees?
I have a high school degree, and I've attended Pensacola State College and the University there.
And I think you went over this, but just to flush this out, you received specialized training in the form of forensic analysis, forensic science. Can you flush that out a little bit more for the jury, just in terms of, I'd like you to limit it to two specific areas, if you can. Bloodstain pattern analysis, and also what would fall under the umbrella of crime scene reconstruction.
Okay. I have received a lot of training in the area of bloodstain pattern analysis, because if you look at the blood at the scene, it will give you volumes of information concerning the crime scene reconstruction.
Have you ever published in the field of forensic science?
When I worked for the Florida Department of Law Enforcement, again, I was one of six members that wrote the manual within the laboratory. Actually written a chapter on crime scene safety in Richard Saperstein's book, and currently working on the book itself.
Have you ever been qualified as an expert witness in the field of crime scene reconstruction?
Yes.
If you had to take a guess, how many jurisdictions would you say you've been qualified in?
Probably just about every county within the state of Florida, in Tennessee, Alabama. I do a lot of cases in Alabama. I've been qualified as an expert in the country of Bermuda, testified in Bermuda, numerous times, maybe New Jersey.
So same question, but for blood stain patterns.
The same. I've testified in all those regions. Reconstruction and analysis.
Can you give the jury a brief description of what crime scene reconstruction is?
Basically, we go based upon the scientific methodology, which is evaluating the crime scene and the evidence that is gathered and documented at that scene. As a reconstructionist, oftentimes you don't have the opportunity go to the scene, so you have to work from somebody else's work product. So, collecting all the data, getting all the pieces to the puzzle, which is the autopsy report, all the lab reports, the police reports, going over all the information, coming up with a hypothesis, testing that hypothesis, and then the end result is your final conclusions based upon the forensic science available to you with the case.
Is there somewhat of a subjective element to crime scene reconstruction?
Yes. Objectivity is based upon the forensic findings and the forensic facts, but sometimes you have to be subjective in the analysis.
And can you briefly explain the science of bloodstain pattern analysis for the jury?
When you look at bloodstain pattern analysis at a crime scene, you always look at the size of the stain, the shape, surface onto which blood has been deposited. The size of the stain, the more force, the more energy that's applied to the blood, the smaller the droplets. Okay? And then you look at the shape of the stain. Stains that are very circular or very round are indicative of stains that drop either vertical or horizontal at 90 degrees. Stains that are basically 60 to 40 degrees are shaped more like a bear's claw. They are starting to form an ellipse. And stains that are 30 to 10 degrees are very elliptical in shape. One may determine the direction of travel of the blood by looking at the edge characteristics.
And do you have a PowerPoint presentation that would assist you in explaining the art of bloodstain pattern analysis to the jury?
Yes, I do.
Judge, with that, I'll go for what's been presented to counsel is D63 into evidence. I'll proffer that it's a disc containing two PowerPoints, one that I'll work in at a later point, one with a brief explanation of bloodstain pattern analysis.
Any objection?
Judge, with that,